Hey there, everybody. Welcome to a new NCIS video, but not your typical NCIS video.
Nope.
Recently, we had a chance to talk to none other than showrunners Steve Binder and Frank Cardea, who we routinely shout out in these videos, acting as though they're magically like listening to them like 15 minutes in.
Yep.
But we actually had a chance to get some scoop for what's coming up. Season 18 is premiering next week.
Yep, and we got some scoop on McGee and Delilah and their relationship. We got some scoop on whether or not Ziva's going to be coming back this season. There's a little bit about Torres in there. There's some stuff about Gibbs. There's a lot going on.
We're just going to dive headfirst into this because we don't want to make you guys wait too much longer to get to any of this good stuff. But before we get into it, if you guys enjoy this video, subscribe. That is the best way to stick around here. Make sure you don't miss any other updates, especially since we've got a lot of NCIS coverage coming.
Tons of NCIS coverage coming.
It is almost here.
All right, so we're going to start with McGee and Delilah because they're a couple that a lot of us really love. We didn't get to see any of them really last season at all. They were planning on having something, but the season got cut short. They weren't able to do it. So they have told us that there is going to be some McGee and Delilah stuff coming up this season. And that it's going to be about them kind of hitting a little bit of a rough patch in their marriage. And for me personally, I'm not too worried. Like, I don't feel like they're going to divorce these two or anything like that. But it does give us a chance to sort of see the realities of marriage and relationships in general, that they're not always blue skies and smooth sailing. There are rough patches that come in and how they deal with them and how they get past them. And I'm really glad that the show is looking at that, because a lot of the relationships, you know, are kind of off screen a lot and we don't get to see them. It's just sort of happy, smooth sailing. So this is something that is going to be coming up for these two. A little bit of trouble, but I have faith.
I have faith too. This is the thing. We're already dealing with, you know, a global health crisis, a lot of other very just sad things that have gone on in 2020. I don't think NCIS and Steve and Frank are going to be like, now we're going to lump McGee's divorce on top of everything, especially since fans already have to deal with the idea of Maria Bella leaving. Like, we don't need more sadness with this show. I think ultimately they will work through it, but it's one of these situations where, you know, they've got young kids. They both are very, very busy career-wise. Maybe it's just a situation where they haven't really had a lot of time for each other and to work on that part of their lives.
Yeah, and sometimes you do have to go through those rough patches to get out on the other side stronger. And that's where I feel like we're going with that.
All right.
All right, let's get into the Ziva of it all, because we, like you guys, have been wanting more of Ziva. Mm-hmm. I mean, it was such a great arc last season. We got a lot of her last season. Are we getting any more of her this season?
Okay, let's look. Probably not. I don't want to say for sure no, but it doesn't sound like it is in the plans right now. And the way that Steve and Frank sort of explained it is, for starters, if you guys didn't know, we're only going to have 16 episodes as of right now instead of 20 to 24 because of what's going on in the world. And they started late, so they only have a limited amount of episodes that they have. And they are already dealing with a really big Gibbs story that we'll be getting into pretty soon here. They already have Maria Bello's exit to think about. There's a lot of other stories. And the way that they sort of described it is, having Ziva and trying to fit her in here would be like putting a hat on top of a hat. It's just they don't want to bring Ziva back, I think, for the sake of bringing Ziva back. Like, they want there to be an awesome story like we had this past season, and it just sounds like they don't have that story right now that justifies the return of someone who is that epic.
Yeah, she's really valuable, and her time is valuable, and having her on the show is valuable, and I think they just don't want to shoehorn her in there just for the sake of having her on the show. They want to have something that's, you know, really meaty for her to come back and a reason for her to come back. She's not just coming back to come back. So it seems like we're not going to see her this season.
I would be surprised unless they are, like, pulling some straight-up shenanigans on us, which I don't think that they are. I think that they are trying to be realistic about sort of where they are. Plus, can you imagine them, like, going, you know, to Cody and trying to pitch her on a story where, okay, guess what, in this episode, you're going to get, you know, go get lunch for everyone at the team, and then you'll kind of, like, help with one of their cases. That's not, like, a meaty, exciting storyline.
No, there's got to be reason behind it. And with everything that they have going on, like, we're going to start talking about the first five episodes are all going to sort of be set in the past. It's all going to be about what happened with the musical chairs episode where we saw Gibbs come back with a black eye and all that. There is a lot that is happening in these 16 episodes. There's so much to pack in that, for me personally, I want to see Ziva come back, but I don't need to see her come back, and I don't want to see her come back where she's just being kind of like fit in around a bunch of other stuff that's happening. I want it to be like it was last season, where it was like a really juicy, good, smart story.
And with talking about juicy stories here, that moves us into the third thing to discuss, and that is, of course, Gibbs, because you've probably heard already that they're going to be doing something where this first handful of episodes, five in particular, are going to be set in the past. You're going to see maybe a tiny bit of the present or the present-ish at the start of Sturgeon season, the premiere, and then we are jumping right back into that musical chairs era, which you referenced.
Yeah.
This is going to be kind of weird how it's set up, where it sounds like these first five episodes, like we said, it's going to be about this era. There'll be some continuous stuff there, but there's also still going to be like a kind of case of the week element that all of this stuff is going to still be in the past for these five episodes. I don't know how all this is really going to work.
Yeah, they're still going to make it that this is the NCIS that everybody knows and loves. This isn't going to be like five or six episodes of this serialized story arc that's going like huge, and if you miss an episode, you're lost. They're not going to do that to you, but there will be a thread that will go through these episodes.
It seems like a lot of it, at least at first, is tied to Gibbs and Fernell and Fernell's daughter, which you saw established in Daughters at season 16 finale. And it seems like come like episode six or so, they're going to start to wrap things up. But then in episode 7, they're going to sort of bring you forward to a post-pandemic world based on what Steve and Frank had to say.
Yeah, which is really hopeful. And I really like that they're doing something like this, because honestly, we just don't know what it's going to look like. What is a post-pandemic world going to look like? You know, if you get really bleak, you know, is it going to happen? So the idea that they're bringing us into this sort of post-pandemic, where we are going forward, hopeful, I really like that. And that is one of the things that NCIS does really well, is they balance out sort of these really dark, grim cases with a lot of sort of lightness and laughter and hope. And I like that.
This, I think, is the biggest challenge that like any showrunner is dealing with right now, because we've covered some stuff, especially on the site, that is very, very much set in the age of the health crisis. And I've seen a lot of reaction be really, really negative, where people are sort of like, we want an escape. And I think what NCIS is doing is smart. Like, they're not pretending like the pandemic hasn't happened, and you'll probably see a little bit of it, but they're also giving people distractions. They're giving people a chance to just sort of smile, watch some casual banter, watch Gibbs yell, grab your gear at people. You know, the things that we love about this show.
So also, this arc is going to affect Gibbs greatly. Like, that's what they said to us, that this is going to be something that's really going to stick with him, is really going to affect him. And we have seen over the past few years that Gibbs has been changing and he's been growing, and he's still that same guy, but like all of us, you know, we're still the same at our core, but we do change as life goes on, and as things happen and events happen that really affect us and make a change in us, you know, this is going to be happening to Gibbs as well.
The question that I have, and I tried to ask Steve and Frank a little bit about this too, and they were very cryptic in response to it, was just the idea of, okay, so Gibbs, he's changing a lot, and he's gone through a lot, seemingly, like you just said, in these first handful of episodes. And this is all in the past. So whatever happens here, Gibbs has sort of just held on to some huge secret from the rest of the team. Like, all this stuff we saw at the end of seasons this past season, he already had gone through this stuff. So why was he keeping it from everyone? Or if he wasn't, why were they keeping it from us?
Yeah, and I mean, keeping in whatever this secret is that's going to affect him as greatly as it is, I mean, he carries a lot of weight with him anyways on his shoulders. So there's sort of only so much even the strongest shoulders can carry before it's enough.
I'm really curious about it. I don't know when we're going to get an answer. But finally, let's talk some Torres, because I think this is just fun. Like, this is the sort of stuff I like to see on NCIS.
Yeah, so we asked a little bit about Torres and sort of what we're going to see with him. And we're going to see more of Torres's home life. And he's one of the people that we really haven't sort of seen a lot of. Like, yeah, we get him in his working out and lots of dates and all that sort of thing. And we've seen the sister once, and then, you know, there hasn't been much mention of that bit of his home life since then. But it sounds like, you know, we're going to get a little bit more of that.
Yeah, they've said at least there's going to be a mention of the sister. I know there's curiosity out there about Torres's family and all of that. That's going to happen. They were kind of coy on whether or not, you know, we would actually see more of Torres's family. But seeing sort of where he lives, how he kind of goes about his business. Like, I imagine in my head, Torres has got like 5 ellipticals like scattered throughout his house. His like fridge is just like one side of it is like protein shakes and just that. I just want to know more stuff.
And then he's got pictures of himself everywhere flexing.
It's sort of like when, you know, we saw Abby's house after so many years.
Yes.
Way back when, and that was exciting because it was, we all kind of have these pictures in our heads. I want more of this for Torres. Obviously the Bishop and Torres stuff is interesting. Who knows if they'll ever actually fully go to, what is it we called it, Ellic Avenue,
because Sliv Street coming to an end. We got 8 episodes and that is all we got.
There better be some like big block party on Sliv Street at the end of this. Like,
yep.
That's all I'm saying.
Yeah.
We'll see exactly where things go. Hopefully we have some exciting stuff for every character, but those are some of the things that Stephen Frank had to say to us.
Yep.
You can check out the full interview. We'll put a link in the description below, but what do you guys want to see on NCIS Season 18? Let us know in the comments. And if you do like this video, give us a like, subscribe, support us further. Check those links to the store or Patreon. And we'll see you here next time.